Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel Life Science with KMD. Today I am going to explain about strain improvement in algal cultivation. Now what are the ideal characteristics of a strain? In case of algae, the rapid growth has to be seen. That means the multiplication of any algae which will be utilized for strain improvement has to have a rapid growth. If it is not, then it should be improved through strain improvement method. Then another thing is genetic stability. Since algae will be grown outdoor, there will be a harsh environmental condition and there is no stability of the environmental condition. So that even in that harsh condition, the genetic material has to be stable. That means it should not get mutated. Then next is non-toxicity to human, then ability to use cheaper substances for its growth. Like we will use many chemical substances which are laboratory grade. So the algae which has to be improved has to have a ability to grow in a cheaper chemical compound, not the commercial one. Then elimination of the production of compound that may interfere with downstream processing, like some of the toxins can be eliminated at the beginning itself during downstream processes. Then to improve the use of carbon and nitrogen source, like absorption, like if the growth of the algae is more, then indirectly both carbon and nitrogen source which are present in the medium will be utilized for their growth. So in that way we can improve the absorption of carbon and nitrogen source. Then reduction of cultivation cost. If the growth is more and it can able to have a genetic stability and it is non-toxic to the human and it can able to utilize the cheaper substances or the compounds, chemical compounds in the medium, then obviously the reduction of the cost for the production of the algae will be reduced. Now what are the approaches for strain improvement? There are three main approaches. One is mutant selection, second is the recombination, and the third one is recombinant DNA technology. First we have to select the algal system. And then we have to screen for the bioactive compounds. It could be either bioactive carotenoids or the pigments, then, or it could be a oil content which can be used for biofuel purpose. Then after screening the bioactive compound, that algae was subjected to experimental design and approaches. One of them is the mutagenesis, in which UV light or gamma ray irradiation or even chemical mutagen can be utilized. Later, after mutation experiment, then that algae should be screened for adaptive laboratory evaluation, or it could be done like the screening of the experimental design can be done by genetic engineering and synthetic biology, where using in silico design for algal strains, like using bioinformatics, we can design the experiment. Later, experimental validation and data analysis will be done. Then development of algal cell factory, which is having the higher yield, can be utilized for hypothesis driven modeling. Then recovery and application of these bioactive compounds will be done. Genetic transformation can be done through agrobacterium mediated transformation, or it could be by electrophoration or particle bombardment method. So how these methods are employed in algae for the strain improvement will be explained in detail. TI plasmid. TI plasmid is a tumor inducing plasmid or tumor induction plasmid. It is found in Agrobacterium tumefaciens bacteria. Now this bacteria is a gram negative soil bacteria which naturally transform the plant cell, resulting in crown gall tumors, infect plant through breaks or wounds. Tumor formation is the result of integration of tDNA, that is transfer DNA, into the plant genome. Now this is the picture of a TI plasmid. It consists of a origin of replication site, vir gene region, and opine catabolism region. Here there will be a tDNA region which consists of a left border and a right border. Along with it, it has auxin, cytokine, and opine synthesizing site. Now this is the picture of a infection process. Here first the wounded plant cell produces astrocyrinogen. The astrocyrinogen will be detected by the vir gene and it will helps in removing the tDNA from the TI plasmid. Now this single stranded tDNA enter inside the plant cell, where the tDNA from the cytosol will enter inside the nucleus of the plant cell, and there it will start to integrate itself into the DNA or the genome of the host cell. After that, it will transcription will take place and translation will take place, which led to the synthesis of auxin, cytokines, and opines. These auxin and cytokine synthesis promote the tumor formation in agrobacterium infected plant cell, whereas the opine which was synthesized will move outside the plant cell, and that will be utilized by the agrobacterium for its metabolic activity. In case of electrophoration, which comes under physical gene transfer method, the electrophoration involves the creation of pores in the cell membrane using electric pulses of high field strength. If DNA is present in the buffer solution at sufficient concentration, it will be taken up through these pores. Next method is particle bombardment. It is also known as microprojectile bombardment or biolistic or gene gun. The foreign DNA is coated with high velocity gold or tungsten particle to deliver the DNA into the cell. This method is widely used because of its ability to transfer the DNA into the microalgae. Now, one of the examples for strain improvement is the genetic engineering approach, especially transformation work has been done on Haematococcus pluvialis, which produce a pigment called astaxanthin. Now, this astaxanthin is a natural pigment, or it can be utilized as a natural food colorant. Since synthetic pigment or synthetic colorants are carcinogenic, the demand for this astaxanthin has been increased. But this algae, that is Haematococcus pluvialis, cannot be grown outside because it usually grow optimum in temperature at 25 degrees centigrade, and since this is a freshwater algae, it will get contaminated with other rotifers and other algal contamination. So to solve this problem, genetic transformation of a gene which is responsible for the synthesis of astaxanthin will be done. Now the gene which is responsible for the synthesis of astaxanthin will be transferred to Dunaliella bardavil, which is a halo tolerant algae. This algae can be grown outdoor, and this algae could not able to produce astaxanthin, but since they are transformed with astaxanthin gene, after transformation this algae could able to produce the astaxanthin. They have a pathway for the production of beta carotene, but not the astaxanthin. Since the genetic transformation through agrobacterium mediated transformation has been done on Dunaliella bardavil, this algae can able to produce the astaxanthin in outdoor condition. Since they are halo tolerant, contamination with other rotifers and other microalgae
will be reduced, and they produce the beta carotene, or the transform cells can produce astaxanthin under a stress condition, especially under high light and high salt concentration. So in this way, the problem with the astaxanthin production in the algae can be solved. Next method is mutant selection. Mutation is a sudden and heritable change in the trait of an organism. The application of mutagen to induce mutation is called mutagenesis. Agent capable of inducing mutation are called mutagens. Chemical mutagens like alkylating agent, acrylidin dye, etc. can be used for inducing the mutagenesis. Then mutation occurred without any specific treatment is called spontaneous mutation. Mutations are resulting due to the treatment of certain agent is known as induced mutation. Chemical mutagens such as ethyl methane sulfonate, nitroso methyl guanidine, N-methyl N-nitroso urea. These chemical mutagens can be used to induce a mutation. Then next is a physical mutagen like UV light, gamma and X-ray can be used to induce mutation. Next is isolation of mutants. Following points highlights the four methods to detect and isolate the mutant. One is a replica plating technique, and another one is a resistance selection method, or it could be substrate utilization method, or it could be carcinogenicity test. Recombination. It is defined as a formation of new gene combination among those present in the different strain. Recombination is used for both genetic analysis as well as strain improvement. To generate new product, recombination may be based on transformation, conjugation and other crossover and transduction. In case of transformation, the uptake of plasmid DNA by E. coli is carried out in ice cold calcium chloride, which is in the temperature of about 0 to 5 degrees centigrade, and subsequent heat shock of about 37 to 45 degrees centigrade for about 90 seconds. That will lead to the transformation. Some of the problem which algal production or cultivation face through are the contamination with fungi. First, the fungi attaches to the algae, then it will penetrate itself and then start absorbing the nutrients from the algae. Once the contamination of fungus increases, the algae will turn into brown color. Now in this picture, you can see the healthy algal culture and a infected algal culture, which was infected with the fungus. Different pesticides, example Omega-500F, is used for crop protection, that means the algal protection against the pest and predator. Example is chytrid, which is a fungus in outdoor pond cultivation. Some algal strains are sensitive to the therapeutic dose of Omega-500F, causing decreased productivity. A strain with increased tolerance to Omega-500F could be improve overall productivity. Now, laboratory discovery of Omega-500F tolerant mutant. First step is the determination of screening concentration. Then mutation will be done by using UV light. Later on, liquid screening is done. Then primary validation of both the control and the biocide will be done. Later on, lab validation experiment with biocide can be compared with that of the control. And here we can see the treated plate has shown the screening concentration. Then that concentration will be utilized for the field trial. In the field trial, we can see that the culture, when it was infected with the fungus, when it is grown in the outdoor, the pond which was treated with the biocide, that is omega 500 HEF, has shown a nice growth compared to that of a control culture which doesn't have any biocide, that is omega 500 HEF. And even we have to compare the biomass productivity and oil content if it is used for the biofuel purpose. Strain improvement in case of macroalgae. Macroalgae are usually referred as seaweeds. Macroalgae are used extensively in food and nutritional industry for their high nutritional value. Also, they are used in pharmaceuticals, cosmetics, as well as biofertilizer industries. Edible seaweeds have high nutritional content as they are low caloric food but rich in vitamins, minerals, and dietary fibers. Also, in the production of carrageenan from kappa ficus, agar from gracilaria, and the production of porphyra, which is a nori. Strain improvement in macroalgae is achieved by selecting breeding, line breeding, or genetic modification using mutagenesis and Colchicine treatment. Genetic modification is most preferred method out of all. Now, already I have explained about genetic modification as well as mutagenesis. Next, we are going to see about the selective breeding and line breeding. In case of selective breeding, the breeder select two parents that have beneficial phenotypical characters to reproduce, yielding offsprings with those desirable traits. Line breeding is an inbreeding program whereby an individual is mated to its descent or the ancestor, and even traditionally a single male is bred with many females. So this is the difference between selective breeding and line breeding, which are used in case of macroalgae. Mainly in macroalgae, the breeding purpose will be selected. Thanks for watching my video. Please subscribe to my channel by clicking on subscription button. Subscription doesn't cost you any money. To get a notification, click on a bell icon. Do like and share this video with friends and family. If you have any kind of feedback, do share it on a comment box. Thank you.